You want to play a song? I'm going to introduce it.
Nah, just introduce it, man. My bad. Joe!
Looking like Kawhi out here, man.
Because, like, I didn't want to just play a random song. Like, we're in like, a Doom kind of mix, so exactly. I would have felt bad.
Nah, I hear you. What episode is this? 96? 26?
This feels like 106. Like, we should definitely be over 100.
I'm going to just say this is episode 96 of the Soapbox. You're here with your boy, Sonny Tay. We got Karan in the building, a.k.a. Amal.
What up?
With the hoodie on, you know, black on black, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Every day is Black Friday.
Talk about it. Hold on, let me get an air. We got Solange in the building, aka Solange, chilling.
Yo, Dante's running with that name.
Oh,
bro.
I'm running with it. She gonna be all right.
She you know what I'm saying?
Cozy out here. How you doing? Mm-hmm. We got Sam in the building. I don't have a nickname for you yet, but it is coming.
So I call her Young Sam. Wait. I like saying Young Sam.
Young Sam.
Sam.
Yeah.
I'm not that much younger than you.
That is true, but
I think it fits though.
It does.
You didn't even good rap think name. I was.
You didn't.
I didn't what?
You None didn't think that he was 20. She was 20.
I was 22. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
None of y'all thought that I was like 22.
Yeah, I didn't. That's I true. Thought he was like mad younger than us. Yeah. How y'all doing, man? How y'all doing? Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, guys.
You know what I'm saying?
How you guys do?
Played the crib. I popped the bottle outside my front porch, back porch. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah. You just sent a video, right?
Yeah, man. I poured one out for my dead homies and for my homies that's currently living. But, you know, it was fun.
Solange went to a party.
Yeah.
Wow. Wasn't a family party.
It was still a party. It don't matter if it's family or not.
Damn, Karan, of like six people.
Okay, oh, it was only six people?
It was only six people.
Just family.
All right. I thought it was more than six people.
Wally, you thought I was outside in the streets and shit like that. That's crazy.
I'm sorry. I know how y'all get, you know.
How we get.
Yeah,
how was your New Year's?
No, she's not stupid.
Yeah, Solange is very smart. I'm sorry, Solange. My New Year's is cool, man. I just stayed at the crib. I didn't do anything.
You didn't do nothing?
Honestly, like, since I wasn't, like, people kept making me feel bad that I was just at the house. So, you know what I actually did? I started reading a book. Like, I picked up a new book.
Okay.
And, like, I was like, I might as well be productive. Mm-hmm.
What's the book that you read?
Yeah.
It's Gary Keller's Millionaire Real Estate. Mm-hmm. It's just, like, gives, like, insight on just, like, business and the mindset of, like, making deals and stuff like that.
Okay.
And stuff like that. And, oh, I also took my bed apart and... like put it together.
I'm living on the floor
for the new year.
I try to be productive as much as I can, but yeah, it was good.
That's
it was cool.
Good way to start off the new year.
Yeah.
How was your New Year, Sam?
I spent New Year's Eve getting some drinks with one of my friends, and then
that sounds fun.
I stayed over her house, and it was just her and her family. So it was like just the four of them.
Mm-hmm.
Played Bananagrams.
So Bananagrams.
That sounds like a great time.
It's like
Scrabble without the board.
Yeah, and you kind of have to do it fast.
Mm.
Like, you have to think on the fly. It's not like Scrabble where you can take your time.
Yeah.
Okay, it's like more hectic.
Yeah.
It's like a hectic version of Scrabble.
Yeah, you got all the tiles, and you got to split them up between, like, how many are playing.
Mm-hmm.
And then somebody goes, like, they say peel or whatever, and you start... And every time you get a word, you say peel, and you have to grab, like, two tiles or whatever. And you just keep adding to your pile and trying to make words out of your thing. And if you don't finish with all of your words, you obviously lose.
Sounds fun. Sounds like a crazy, hectic night you had, Sam.
Oh, yeah.
I'm playing. I mean, like, sounds very intimate. Sounds very nice, though.
Yeah, exactly.
Like it.
See, like, very we don't
intimate.
Need
people. That
we don't need, like, a big party.
That is true.
I had a great New Year's just in my bed, bro. I'm not going to hold you.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. I'm not really a New Year's type of guy.
I used to be. Oh my god! Really? Like maybe the last 6-7 New Years, I was out. Like
word.
Out. Like,
I was
until
out
like 8 in the morning. Out like
really?
Oh yeah, those were good times.
I only done that one time, bro. I can't.
Really? Nah, you definitely. Oh my god. Like
New
two
time.
Yeah, 2 years ago, you went. We went out to Mad Bars in Goshen. And remember, you came with
Goshen?
Us. Yeah, oh yeah.
Nah, well, it should be lit sometimes, bro. Sometimes.
Well, I'm trying to think. We might have like went to New, bro. Like we were just going to a whole bunch of bars upstate.
I
like,
was like, Goshen is not.
Well, we did hit a few bars in Goshen. We were just everywhere. Like
New Street be lit though. I'm not gonna hold you. That's a big
New, like
reunion.
New Year's. Yeah, it's like everyone's
lit.
There.
It was lit.
It makes me cringe.
That was and a fun night.
Easy because it's in town. You don't have to drive too far. Like you know,
that's true.
So if you get a little buzz, you know, you could just walk home or something.
No.
Yeah. No, you're not walking.
You're not walking in Goshen.
Why not?
Because it's so white.
Didn't Henry and them walk from the bar to his house one time?
Yeah, but Henry's not doing shit. Like,
you live like past Goshen.
Oh yeah, I'd be
worried for like you two walking home. Yeah,
he can't walk home.
Nah. Like, on the trail. I'm going to be on the trail walking. I've done that so many times. That's scary. We're like,
dude, that's not that far, to be
the
honest.
The trail freaks me out any
night,
time of the day.
At night absolutely bro. Not.
Nah, I never, like, well, I remember a few times I missed the bus that's and like I had to go to school and had to like take the trail to school.
Dang. To Goshen?
It's like four miles maybe.
That's a good 2 hours. How the fuck you get to school?
What? No?
You did not walk the trail to Goshen.
I swear to God. Like, to the school. It's not that
he
far.
Only lives I'm not gonna say right. It
yeah, don't say my address or my road. By Hacienda, I'll say that. By Hacienda, yeah.
No, that's
so like
fakey.
The trail's not far. From
not that far.
It's not far, but
it'll take
far
you.
Walk.
It's like an hour and a half. It's like an hour and a half.
No, because a half a mile is 15 minutes.
Yeah, it took me like an hour and a half. It wasn't bad, but yeah. So y'all had a good New Year's, huh?
I'm so stuck with the fact that you really walked all that, bro.
It's not that bad. Like, I've walked the trail so many times in my life. It's not that bad. It's
that's a typical
literally like
walk.
5 miles.
I don't know.
5-6 miles.
But yeah, my New Year's was good. It was good.
Didn't you run track? How's that surprising?
Listen, I didn't run track. I was a sprinter. Your boy can't do no distance. After a mile, tie me out, coach. I'm out of
damn.
Here.
You don't know how to pace yourself, huh?
Yeah, I don't. Because my mind is always to be fast. So, like, I can't.
It's not a good mindset.
Myself. It's not. But, you know, that's just how I am. In the track field. Now, in life.
Slow and steady wins the race.
I'm slow. I'm
slow and
steady.
It's a marathon, not a sprint, Dante. Life's a marathon.
Yeah, that's me in life.
R.I.P. Nipsey. Oh, I can never do yoga. I can't even imagine.
Really?
Oh, yeah. No.
Like I can meditate.
I feel like that works for you.
I can meditate. I can't do yoga.
I can sit and breathe. I'm just not flexible.
I
like
can't
I can't.
Have to be I can't
flexible.
Get my mind
that's not
quiet.
The point of yoga. Yoga is also about strength. More
but like
than the
it is,
flexibility.
It is about strength.
But
and
as far
it's
as
about training.
But like
your
I can't
breath.
See myself. Well, I could like do breath control, but I can't see myself holding a position. Like that would be really
you
hard.
Don't have to do
or even just like
positions.
Sitting crisscross. Like I can't do all
it's
that
yeah.
for a long time. Yeah.
Like if you have a good instructor, they will make sure that you're not doing something that you clearly like. If you're if you can't do a position,
mm-hmm.
they'll know.
They'll know. Like,
they'll know. Okay. They'll correct you. They'll help you get the form that you need.
Mm. Okay. Well, yeah, I'm sure. Well, like, if I had a yoga instructor there to like actually help with my form, it would probably be like much easier.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Because I've tried to do like yoga, like look at stuff online and like
I want
to
do yoga.
No,
try to
do like,
stuff like that.
Easy things, like start off easy. Because sometimes yoga isn't necessarily about holding the pose. Sometimes it's just straight up cardio.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes
yeah.
it's just like working out and like
that's true.
It really is a workout.
Power hits, yeah.
That's a fact.
New Year's resolution: everyone joins yoga.
Scry always says that.
No, this is like because I know the transitions. Like I know like the key words. Like that's one of the key words. That's a fact. Anyway, and then jump into something else. I just peeve it.
No, I was gonna say for 2021, I actually do wanna try yoga. I wanna try my luck in yoga.
Really?
Like,
I can see Dante doing yoga.
I can meditate, but I can't do yoga, bro. Because I just can't imagine really? Myself just sitting there. And I'm not flexible. Mm. Like
yeah, I'm not flexible.
Crisscross
at all.
Applesauce.
I can't.
My
do that.
Legs be hurting, bro.
I be getting numb. Like
yeah,
I be feeling like
bro.
I'm about to need to chop off my leg.
Like I can't.
I can't
like mentally get that out of my head to like not. Worry about the numbness. Like,
yeah, it's
it.
Hard.
Like, yo, even with me, like, cuddling with my girl, like, I can't fucking.
And your muscles yeah, have to be activated while you sit there. That's the entire point. You can't just, like, sit there and just, like, expect shit to happen and everything just be loose. You have to activate your muscles.
Yeah.
Dante, you ever been laying down with a woman and, like, like literally your hand just falls, but you can't
yeah,
do nothing. Like, you just gotta stay
there.
Sit there,
bro. And then after you get up, your legs. Like,
you gotta put your hand
OD,
all the way up
bro.
And have the blood drain.
OD, bro.
Yeah, it's hard.
That should be worth it, though, sometimes. I'm not gonna
we gotta get flexible, man. I'm not gonna
I
lie.
To get flexible. I can't
that might this. Help out, like, our lives so much.
Yeah, I'm too stiff.
I'm very
stiff.
Bro.
I need to really
do yoga.
I'm gonna do it.
We're gonna do it.
I'm gonna do yoga.
We should make that a family trip. When things open up, have
Soapbox
a go to
yoga.
Yoga trip, a yoga studio or something.
There's one open in Chester, actually. Oh, body damn. And art barn.
It'll catch me in like 6 months, and maybe
I'm
we can.
Yeah,
I'm not
going.
I'm not doing
for.
That right now.
I'm not gonna do it during quarantine.
Yeah.
All right, you want to get into the sad stuff? Well, one
oh,
sad
yeah.
thing.
Yeah, definitely. R.I.P. I'm MF Doom. I wish. What's his real name? Well, we know him as MF Doom. I guess.
Yeah, keep him on the low.
Yeah, he was known. He was known for being like anonymous and
Danielle Dumel. If I said that correct,
is he from like New Rochelle?
He is Mount Vernon? From New York City.
I was about to say
he's from somewhere in New York City, but
Danielle Dumel.
Oh no, he was. Dumel? Yeah, no, he was actually born in London.
He was.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I do remember that.
Born in London, raised in the city.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think his parents were like in the military, so they traveled like a lot. He was born in London. But definitely, like, as far as the sound, like, the underground hip-hop sound now, MF Doom definitely, like, he's been making music since the early 90s, but as far as, like, the boom bap,
Long Island.
Okay, yeah. Okay. That makes sense, actually. Mm-hmm. But, yo, as far as, like, the soundscape of, like, music, and there's so many people that their sound, like, comes from MF Doom, whether they know it or not.
Yep.
Like, if it's from people like Joey Badass or, like, just the people... the underground hip-hop scene, like, a lot of the sound comes from him. Mm-hmm. Like, the inspiration from, like, Alchemist Beats to, like Madlib to... I mean, this it sounds, like, really, like, hip-hop-ish. And,
yeah.
Like, but honestly, like, that's what the sound is, and he kind of started the sound. So, like, a lot of people don't know, like, they know of the sound, but they don't know of him.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, I think it's good to just appreciate that and acknowledge that. And I wish, like, people would acknowledge him more, like, when he was alive. But he was, like, really low-key, so I don't think he really cared about, like, the acknowledgements. So.
Yeah, I agree. I'm not even going to cap. I never really got into his music before he passed. So I kind of sucked that I had to get into music now when he died.
Yeah.
That kind of sucked. But, like, I feel like I still loved him. But back then, when I was getting into, like, hip-hop, if I got to him first, I would have, like, he probably would have been one of my favorite rappers.
Yeah, I could see that.
Because I just love, like, his beat selection was really good.
His sound, I can see you liking his sound.
His flow, the sound. Like, I love every song I heard from him, I liked all of it off the rip.
Mm.
So it was sad that I had to wait until he passed away to get into his music, but... Yeah.
Sometimes that's how it is. That happens. I mean, I feel really bad. That kind of happened to me with Nipsey. Like, I listened to him. I kind of listened to him a lot, but after he died, like, I really got into all his music. I'm like, damn, like, there was so much that when he was alive, I didn't appreciate until after he died. So
it hasn't come out to how he died yet.
Yeah.
But I didn't know. He died all the way in Halloween, and they kept it under wraps this whole time.
Really?
He died back in Halloween.
No way. That was really...
He died back in Halloween. His family members hit it.
Wow.
And they just announced it.
Well, I know he was, like... I don't want to say he was overweight, or I don't know, like, the health issues, but, like, he's always been, like, a bigger guy, you know, and...
Really?
Yeah, like, when he was younger, he kind of, like, his weight fluctuated a lot, and, like, at one point, like, he got really big, and then he got skinny, and then, like, he started to gain weight again, so...
Because I thought recently he was kind of slim.
He looked kind of slim, yeah, like, the recent slim, shit, he looked really slim, so why I feel like he had some type of health issue.
Do you know why he wears that mask? I've always wanted to, like...
I don't know. I feel like it's because he's like a really deep person and he does release a lot of music. So I think, he did kind of talk about it on an interview I did see. He likes to be anonymous just because, like, he likes making different types of music, but he doesn't want, like, someone to just look at his image and be like, he has to stay on this. So he would release a whole bunch of music under different names. So I guess that's where the mask comes in. And he was also, like, a big, like, Marvel comic fan. So with that, and just, like, keeping his music, like, he like, owned all his music, and he was just, like, really into just, like, production. So he just, you know, I guess it was just his way of switching up characters with the mask.
Has he ever showed, like, his face before?
Yeah, definitely. Like, people have seen his face.
Okay. I was just curious, because I've always wondered, like, why he wore that mask. It was so mysterious.
Yeah, but, I mean, it's actually not that common. Like, not a lot of people.
It's not that common.
Yeah,
that's
it's
why
not
I was
really
like,
that common to
why
see
why is he still wearing his mask?
Because anytime he performs, like, unless you just catch him out, like, and you happen to know what he looks like. Mm-hmm. Like, there's people who, I guess, knew what he looked like and took pictures, but he's never been, like, on stage and took off his mask or in an interview. So a lot of people don't know what he looks like. So
okay. Well, RIP to MF Doom.
Yeah, definitely.
Definitely rest in peace.
And check out, like, he has so much music, but definitely the best thing to check out is Food. It came out, like, 2006.
I gotta check that out.
That's probably, like, his most popular. Thing, yeah. And, like, I feel like a lot of people can get into it. A lot of his music, it's like it can be a little hard to get into because it's like a clash of sounds. Like,
That one was really fire.
Yeah, it's really like smooth, and
he has a lot of music. Bro.
Yeah, he has like he And like I said, he releases music under like many names. So like a lot of people might not even know it's him.
That's fire.
Yeah.
That's what happened to me. But it says I'm up to him. So that was just me having a dumb moment.
That's fire. RIP. RIP Death. Oh, you're right. He did have a song with Mishup.
He had a whole album with
him. Oh, last year. Wow.
It came out recently.
Wow. Yeah, that's my favorite too.
It was okay. I gave it a listen. It's cool.
Facts. Damn, I don't know how to transition out of this. So that was a bad way to come into
the new year. I was waiting for it.
That was a bad way to come into the new year.
That was.
It was
because it did happen on New Year's too.
Literally.
Well, we got the news on New Year's. Yeah.
So what else came out? What else is talked about? Something like. Oh, here's something we can talk about actually. So. Which is a crazy transition to come off of MF Doom. So I apologize, it's a weird transition. But I was talking to a friend of mine about, we was talking about like being friends with, being like, you know how one of your friends gets in a relationship, right? So you meet the guy or girl and you guys end up being friends too. Association. And
I mean, I can't relate because none of my friends bring their significant others around me. But
anyways,
yeah, it is sus.
Anyways, it's not sus.
But whatever.
Anyways,
it's cool.
It's not sus.
A little
How
bit.
Is sus?
Because kind
you about to get into this again.
If you trust
we get
your
into it.
Like that, you
we can get into it. It's okay.
Feel comfortable enough to bring
your significant other around your friends.
Exactly. It's not about feeling comfortable. What if
and
I just don't
also,
do it?
That well, are you? Like, I don't know. Reason, it kind of gives off a vibe that you're either ashamed or that you feel your friends won't approve.
Or vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
I have a question,
and
Sam.
And if that's the case either way, I think that kind of tells you what you need to do with either person.
So what if most of the time I enjoy to spend my time with my friends by myself?
Okay.
That's great.
And?
But if you want to build a relationship eventually.
Yeah.
I'm
yeah.
not saying to never Especially bring a girl like, around your friends.
You can't always like foresee somebody like a significant other like staying in your life long term.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you should act day by day and be like, if I really enjoy this person and their influence in my life
mm-hmm.
and they feel the same way, I want them to be and feel a part of my life.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want them to feel excluded. I don't want to exclude them.
Yeah.
I mean,
because
no.
if they're important to you.
Especially if it's, yeah, if it's serious,
them.
It's like.
You don't have to bring them around the boys every time you guys are going
no,
out.
I'm not
exactly.
saying that.
Honestly, it's just the introduction of, like, these are my friends, this is my girl, now y'all know.
I've done that. It's just after that, it's nothing.
What, you stop?
It's not that I stop. It's
like,
just, I just don't. Well, one, it. Never last that long. That's number one. Number two,
no.
Self-reflection.
Love never lasts. Yeah.
Number two,
tear
just
down.
Sometimes. They, sometimes
tear.
I just
take
out
the little mini violin. You need your soundboard, man.
I don't have a violin. Look,
come on, get it.
Come on,
get it.
Do you have a violin? The world's tiniest violin.
Oh my goodness!
This is for Sunny Tay. You gonna find love?
I'm gonna find love
one day.
Okay,
shut up.
What was I?
What was your question?
Oh yeah, it was one never lasts long. Two, sometimes what happens if the girl doesn't like my friends? Then I don't bring them around.
Has that happened? First of all,
yeah, it
if
happened.
The girl doesn't like your friends,
okay.
I feel like you need to do some reflection. Be like, okay, so who's the problem? Like,
nah,
that's
not true.
A fact.
That's not
who's
true.
The factor?
That's not true. That's not true.
Yeah,
that's
it
true.
Is
well,
because it's either maybe your friends aren't true friends, or maybe that partner isn't
no,
a good partner.
That's so true because you say that's not true, and the situation that I'm thinking about, you totally blame the other person.
Well, sometimes
it's
like personalities.
Blame, but you're like you know damn well who the problem was,
and maybe even it's you. You never know.
Ooh.
I mean, sometimes personalities just don't like clash together. So
what are
y'all
talking
about?
Hold up,
yeah, I'm
We're
very
talking about personal stuff. You wanted to talk about personal stuff,
so we talk about.
Let's
personal
do it. Let's
stuff.
Get into Dante's life.
But okay, this well, it's not gonna be mainly about me. We just do it.
It's
in
accountability.
Oh,
general.
Oh yeah. Winky face.
Yeah, in general, I don't believe in that. That if the significant other doesn't like some of the friends that this person may have, that doesn't mean that that's a self-reflection or you got to check your friends. Because I'm pretty sure as women, and prove me if I'm wrong, there's been a male that didn't approve of a girl that you were friends with because they probably had quote-unquote whole tendencies. That doesn't mean that girl's a bad friend to me. So I don't think...
Wait, did you say whole tendencies?
Yeah, he did. Yeah. I was like, wait, none of us brought that up.
Whole tendencies. It's
yeah, like, what?
Okay, but...
I was thinking of a completely different yeah, thing. Yeah, I wasn't thinking about that.
Like what?
I was just thinking, like, just the personalities just don't clash together. Like, either...
So you guys never heard like... of a nigga have a problem with... his girl's friends for being like,
host. Well, I mean, I guess not. Like, I don't know anyone
that's
personally.
None of his business.
But
like, yes, I how have. They live their life. Like,
yes,
how
I have.
They...
Yeah,
niggas be could mad be a jealous
for them not to.
Okay, not so what? Friend. He doesn't like that they're not settled down. That's not his choice to make.
Okay, so to bring it back to a man's perspective, if I have a girl say that they don't like Karan because of his attitude, I don't think that's
oh,
a problem.
Oh yeah, there's been a lot of friends that said that about.
And I don't think that's a problem.
Okay, a lot of yeah. people don't like me because of my attitude, but, like, I don't care about their opinion.
So, there so shouldn't like, be no self-reflection if your significant other doesn't approve of your friends.
No, I think
that's
there should be
different.
Self-reflection.
That is
no.
different.
How is that
no,
different?
There's self-reflection because it's like, your girl, you're bringing your girl around, and now your girl doesn't like your friend. Now, there's a problem within the relationship that you guys have to fix. Not necessarily that it's like, you have to fix something within yourself, but mm-hmm. there's a situation that needs to be solved.
What situation has to be solved?
Your girl doesn't
she's
like your
friends. With the friends.
It's either your
like
significant other, these are all
your
of your relationships.
So now, if you want to have a healthy relationship and still be with this girl, you're going to have to figure out what you
a
need to do.
Compromise or something.
In order
exactly.
to keep her happy and still hang out with your niggas.
That's my beef, but
because, like, you want everyone to live in harmony at the end of the day, but that's obviously, like, unrealistic.
Yeah.
But even with your best friends, you will get tight with them, right?
Yeah, of course.
So there's a difference between somebody who's in a new relationship and somebody who's been in a relationship for, like, X amount of months, and you haven't brought her around your friends.
Yeah.
That's weird. That's sus to me. That seems like you either don't trust her or, like, maybe you don't, like,
or
you're worried about judgment.
Or maybe
from
you don't
sides.
Even, I mean, I understand if you don't see the relationship going that far and you feel like, what's the point of bringing her around my friends if we're not even, like, that serious about it? Mm-hmm. So I do understand from that perspective, but if you actually do care for her and, like, you're going to have her in your life, like, it's like, come on, it's you hang out with your friends,
but even
you're
if
gonna
you're
have
not
to mix
sure
together.
Where the relationship's headed, maybe it could devolve into like some sort of friendship. But either way, you don't want to treat the person like they're
how
not
about,
important enough to meet your friends or like shell them away.
Just isolate them.
Like you don't like your significant other's parents and vice versa, but that's their parents at the end of the day. Like what the fuck are you gonna do?
I don't
like
you keep it cordial. It's respect.
Oh, shit. I was like. But like
it's you keep it cordial, you keep it respect. So I don't know how the same thing can be said for friends. If I don't like
it
my girl's
be,
parents,
you're gonna have respect
then
for them.
It is what
even
it is.
But
have respect.
It's different relationships, but there still needs to be respect. Mm-hmm. The foundation of every relationship is
respect. Exactly.
Yep.
So
why
if
can't
you're
that cordial
going to
come
trust and friends? Respect them, mm-hmm. then like they clearly aren't like meant to be.
I mean.
Life.
No, I hear you. I mean, I don't have a problem if, like, okay, well, I do bring my girl around my friends. I have. Maybe I was with him twice, but I have done it. What I'm saying is that I don't.
It's very loose when you say I have. Yeah, you have.
Yeah, it's just I don't think it has to be, like.
A constant thing.
Constant thing.
Where you guys are always going out and it's like, oh, I'm going with the boys. Do you want to come?
Yeah.
It doesn't have to be a constant thing, but it definitely has to be like, if you guys are getting somewhere in a serious relationship, she's going to want to be in your life more and see who you're hanging around.
But Dante, wouldn't you want like a girlfriend who like you can hang around your friend? Like, honestly, I think that's the best when like I can bring my girl around my friends and we're all just
chilling.
Yeah. Like, do you want that or do you just, I feel like Dante doesn't even want that. Like, he wants to keep his like love life and his friendship life.
Separate.
Completely separate.
But that's not how life works.
Yeah, it is.
But like, I don't want to speak for you. Is that how you feel?
Clutchy. All right.
Clutchy.
So, so yeah. In a way, I guess because I'm very private with just my life in general, I sometimes don't like to mix two parts of my life together. Like when I threw that my backyard party, like the end of summer party. That was the first time I mixed all my different friend groups in one setting. Mm. And I didn't know how it was going to go. Thankfully, it went really well. Like, everybody vibed with each other. Everybody was cordial.
I feel like you can't go wrong with the cookout.
Yeah, but I've been to some cookouts where you have, like, separate groups. Like, everybody's in groups. Everyone's not really together because it's different friend groups.
That's my birthday party.
So, yeah, that was. But
I feel like our friend group, like, I think we do a good job.
Yeah,
like,
I think because we're really friendly social, people. Yeah, social, friendly so people, that's because it worked out. But
I got a question for you, Dante. Mm-hmm. For someone who doesn't like to mix their love lives and their relationships and their friends together, when it comes to looking for a relationship, people usually have that tendency to be like, I'm looking for a friend to have a relationship. Not looking for, like, that saying, like, fucking the friends, but, like, literally people are like, my best friend is my girlfriend.
Yeah. Or, like, ideally, vice that's what versa. I would want, yeah.
So how would you not mix that together?
It's funny because I do believe in that. Because I feel like for you to be my girl, I need to be able to tell you certain shit that I won't even tell my guy friends or my other best friends about. Like, you have to be my best friend. Because I know there's some people that separate boyfriend and girlfriend and best friend. Like, just because you're my boyfriend, that'll make you my best friend. Like, there's some shit I won't tell you. And I'm not like that. Like if you're my girl, you're going to know my emotional side. You're going to know, like, the shit I will never tell my other friends about because you're my best friend. So I'm weird. Like, I want that, but I also don't want... It's not that I don't want to mix it together. It's just I don't want that thing. Like, don't talk about, like you could pinpoint my friends and say that you don't like so-and-so because of this, that, and the third, and then you have every right to do that. But at the end of the day, they're my friends. You know what I'm saying? So if I fuck up and I have a wrong friend, then that's my bad. But I'm very selective with who I decide who's in my circle. So you're not about to come in here and tell me to take this person out of my circle. Because I've experienced that, like, mad times. Like, people try to tell me to stop being friends with a guy sometimes, but most of them just girls, but it also could be a guy, you know, tell me to stop being friends.
Has that ever happened about me as a
girl? Not you. Some girl wanted me to stop being friends with Nakeem.
With Nakeem?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Well, he was a bad influence on your life,
she thought. Yeah.
I can see that.
I can see it too. But that's my son. That's my best friend.
He's a wild boy. Yeah. He's a wild boy. He's not doing anything to inflict on y'all, so.
He could have some influence. We're around him.
The Nakeem is very persuasive, man.
Let me shut my mouth, though.
You're a Virgo. You should know. Virgos are very persuasive.
We have the same birthday. That's why I'm like, I can't see Nakeem like that.
Nah, he's very persuasive.
So, man. Is he like the opposite?
But he's like cool with it. Like, he's not like, he'll be cool with it. Yeah. Like, all right, that's cool. Like, you ain't gotta do it, but you know me. I'm gonna do it. Like, that's some shit. It'll be like,
shout out to Knock.
Yeah, shout out to Knock, man.
But yeah, man. I don't know. Like,
are we gonna call Knock?
Should we call him real
should
quick?
Should we?
Nah. Oh, my phone's over there. Wait.
Should I call my mom?
Yeah, call him. I was gonna do the thing where I could call him on the FaceTime here, but I don't think it works like that.
They don't mess with
the. And I don't think it's gonna mess with the thing, right? Yeah, call him.
Should I like FaceTime him or like
how's your Wi-Fi? Audio?
I'm at my house.
Whichever audio is better.
Do FaceTime audio.
FaceTime audio.
Okay. Yeah.
Is he gonna be up? Is he gonna be alive?
He's a wild boy. He's probably out at the strip club. So.
That's what I was saying.
Oh my.
I'll give him a little call.
I have like. It is 3:35 p.m. What?
I know people who wake up at 5 o'clock.
Yeah, man. He can't be staying up late.
Let's see what he's up to.
Okay. Well. Same.
He's definitely gonna look at my number and be like, "Nah."
Great.
Oh shit. Hello? Alright.
Yo.
What's up, brother? How you doing, man?
Not
kid. Hey. Good job. How you feeling, brother? How you feeling?
You're now on live on a soapbox. Anything you say may be held against you, so relax.
We actually just giving you your props and saying how inspirational and influential you've been. In our lives.
Y'all are not saying that.
Nah, we just talking shit, yo. Yo, what you...
Nikki, where was... What you said?
I appreciate it
anyway. No problem, bro. How you been, bro? How you been?
I'm chilling, bro.
Yo, bro, we've been seeing...
Acting like
coronavirus. That's what we were saying, yo. All right. Well, let's get to it. So we've been seeing... Well, me and Dante, we've been seeing snaps at... You in the strip? You at the strip club, bro? I'm seeing you on.
Yeah, bro. You was you at the strip club in Atlanta?
In Atlanta or some shit?
Nah, I wasn't at a strip club.
We was in a basement with girls just stripping. What the fuck?
It was a lounge.
Oh, that's what they calling it now.
That's what they call it.
That's like the speakeasies now. Oh, we got to keep that on low. Oh, all right.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
We had a section, so we're to ourselves. Mm-hmm.
Talking shit, so, now.
So it's like you still isolated, but within your friend group in the section. Yeah. Okay.
Man, y'all. Big man, not go out to
the section. Oh, what the good shots?
Talking shit, man.
Come on, now.
All right, we were just talking shit about you because we know you're not quarantining out there. We saying,
why are you calling him out on the pie? You about to get this man arrested. Okay.
Talking shit, bro. That's what I like to hear.
I don't want you to sneeze in public because I don't want no old ladies walking through your cloud and catching some shit. Yo, I need you to be safe, man.
Yo, I swear, yesterday was the only time, bro.
Yo, what made you go out to that place, bro? That was like a field of just corona, bro.
Nah, that's what I was just saying. We had a cabana. We paid for a cabana. So it was just going to be up in that section.
Yeah.
But they moved the location. So when they moved it to, there was no cabana.
Okay, okay.
So instead of being responsible and turning around and going home, y'all just said, fuck it.
Nigga, you know how much that fucking cabana was?
You can't get your refund?
Talk your shit.
Okay. Talk your shit, bro. You look... Talk about it, man.
All right. yo, we love you, man, and we miss you. You got to come back on, bro. We need to have you in another episode when you back up here.
I know, bro.
Damn.
You know,
well, Dante, yo, that's a shame if you didn't see Dante. I can understand not me, but
I was gonna come by yesterday, bro. But you was ready.
I was gonna come by yesterday, but
yeah, Dante, bullshit.
Yeah, but then I found out you left already. You left already. I didn't know you left.
Yeah, that defeats the purpose, Dante.
I didn't know you left. When are you coming back up?
This nigga just left. He don't know when he's coming back up.
I'm dead.
This man not coming back up.
I hear that,
bro. We're gonna holler at you, bro.
Later, bro.
Alright, stay up, man. Alright.
Got you, brother.
Play his drop one more time before he leaves.
I got you, bro. Oh, I'm slacking. I'm slacking.
Knock, 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 kid. Yo. All right, we gotta holler at you, bro.
All right, bro.
Man, they need to lock this man up, man. This man out here at a $5,000, like 5,000 people venue. Like,
Cabana, no, you can't, bro. Blast this shit on. No. Y'all are assholes.
Salon, you ain't seen this shit.
I mean, to be fair. He kind of deserves it.
Bro, you ain't see what
you're about to
at.
Lock up your own cousin. That's
okay,
fucked up.
But he's being stupid. No! He deserves it.
All right, well, not your own. Shout out to the key.
That's a fact. How do you get on the key?
talk about influence.
Oh, but my whole. my
girls friends and girls, yeah.
I haven't asked my question yet. Anyway, what I'm saying is that. What I was going to ask you guys was if. Do you guys feel weird to be friends with somebody that your friends used to date?
Oh, a friend's ex?
Yeah.
Was that really the whole point of
it? Yeah, that's what I was trying to get.
I'm fucking dead.
Y'all attacked me about my personal life.
His point was different than yours. And
y'all attacked me about my personal life. Do y'all feel weird that, let's say I had a girl, right? And y'all got mad cool with my girl, blah, blah, blah. Y'all got mad cool. Sometimes you mean her. We broke up. But that doesn't mean that you guys still can't be cool with my girl. But for some reason, I guess it's like friend etiquette. Once that person is broken up with, we don't speak to them anymore like that.
Depending on the person, there definitely is codes.
Depending
on the person and the breakup. It really is about the person and the breakup.
Okay.
Because I'm still friends with mad people that my ex is friends with. And it's about like not breaking the code because we were all friends before we even got together. Okay. But I'm not about to talk to my ex from high school's friends. Like, they could stay in the fucking past. And vice versa. So I feel like it depends on the situation.
Yeah. Personally, I'd never, like, I wouldn't care if, like, one of my friends still had a, like, friendly relationship with one of my exes. Like, I think that's cool. But as far as, like, me doing it, like, I don't know how other people think. So I try to stay away from it. Like, if my friend had an ex, I probably wouldn't, I would try not to associate with her. Just out of respect for my friend.
Just an ex.
Yeah, an ex. Mm-hmm. But honestly, personally, like, Like, my friends could be still be friends with my ex. Like, I don't care.
Okay. I think it depends.
It does depend, though.
Because, like, it depends on how their relationship was mm-hmm. and mm-hmm. how one another treated each other. And how it and ended. How, yes, mm-hmm. especially how it ended. Yeah. Like, it could have ended any which way. And if it ended badly, I personally would not be...
Reach out.
Yeah, no. Yeah. Like, if they reach out to me, they reach out to me, and I deal with it when it happens. But mm-hmm. I also wouldn't reply without consulting that friend first, because mm-hmm. I feel would be keeping a secret from them. Mm. Even though, like, obviously, like, even if I wasn't currently in a relationship, I still would do the same thing, because I feel like I owe that.
What if it's an old ex, like an ex from, like, 10 years ago?
That's still, that's weird. I mean, well, that would how long has it been since you've spoke?
Well, not 10 years. Okay. That's like 10 years.
Yeah. I was about to say. Like,
yeah, like high school 4 years ago, freshman year of college. And then after graduating, you ran into this person at a club, maybe at a bar. Mm. Something mad organic. Okay. Nothing crazy. Like,
I'm like, don't be an asshole, but like.
Yeah. We ain't gotta talk like after the that. Casual, like. How you doing? Yeah.
How's life going?
But you don't necessarily have to
reach out and be like, here's my number, hit me back up whenever you feel like.
Yeah. It's like, is your number still the same? Sorry, I can't hear you over the music.
No, that's actually really funny. That happened to me before. That so fucking happened to me before. I was at a club. Weird ass experience. I was at a club with my teacher.
Yo, Solange be doing some wild shit, man.
Yeah, I fucking love my life. I was at a club with my teacher. She invited me out.
That's cool.
That's so cool. Different, yeah.
Yo, fucking awesome. Fucking love her. Shout out Mara Donahue. You're the fucking
at the
MVP. Club,
at the bar with like...
With an old nigga?
Yeah.
Sugar daddy. I fucking wish. But I went to the club with her.
I can manage that if you want.
Come on, you're not about to manage my life. We already talked about this. But
you're missing out.
Imagine going to a club with your sugar daddy, bro.
I would do it. Okay, back to my story. I was at a club with my teacher, and we met one of my old friends' exes there.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And it was one of those moments where it was like, how you doing? How's life? Explain to my teacher how we know each other. Mm-hmm. It was weird because they broke up, and they had like some little shit going on, and I was like involved in some of the drama without me intentionally knowing that I was involved in some of the drama until I found out mm-hmm. when I met the dude at the club. And he's like, you should hit me back up, da da da. Put me on his coolest friends on Instagram and everything. And I was like,
When you soft block and you like.
I didn't soft block. Like, I still, like, obviously, we don't even talk anymore. But, like, it was just one of those weird ass moments where it's like, I saw you in the club. I'm not going to hit you back up after this, even though it was great people's. But, and it was just really ironic because I stopped talking to the girl, but we kept on continuing talking. And now that we stopped, the girl hit me back up this year.
But what if you guys actually had a chemistry, though? Like,
there was no chemistry.
Like, hypothetically.
It was like a friendship chemistry. Everything was extremely platonic.
But hypothetically, like, let's say you guys did reconnect and had some type of chemistry. Would you, would you kind of dub it just completely since she was, he was an ex of your friend? Or would you feel the need to talk to your friend about it?
Because the thing was, she stopped talking to me after they broke up. That's why it was fucking weird.
Okay.
Sounds like you shouldn't be involved with either.
That's why I just kind of left them there.
Yeah.
I would reply.
One of those things says time.
If I did have chemistry, because in all honesty, it's in the realm of like entertainment and connections are kind of everything. And not saying for the sake of like mooching and connections, but like he was rooming with a couple of musicians. Yeah, it's like sometimes it's worth to have. Yeah, it's worth to have those connections and friendships, because like, I know where I stand on a level of where I am with my relationships, and that's where we're going to keep it a buck.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
She still you know your boundaries.
Person. No, but that was
you know
my
your
answer.
Comfort. You know your boundaries.
I'm sorry, you don't like the answer. He was like, yeah, I'll still talk to them, you know. No, keep it a buck.
You're like, nice seeing you. Literally seeing you.
If you're talking about projects and things that we could do in the future, like the conversation we had with Zeta with friendships, like if we're not benefiting from this friendship, why are we still talking?
But what if you could benefit and you still hit it off with the person?
I wasn't hitting it off with him. I didn't want to.
That's the thing. She keeps saying that there was not.
Like, because hypothetically, I'm not there.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Hypothetically, I'm not. No, I've been surprising myself this year, but I don't see myself.
I can see you keeping it like super professional. Like, Solange is definitely the person who's like, Like, one's like, she's gonna be the homie. Like,
no, she's definitely gonna be the
homie. That's why I gotta ask you the question, Dante. Dante ain't shit.
Not that I ain't shit. It's just I don't care. Like, I'll definitely. No, well, when it comes to friends and exes, I don't touch that. Ever.
Oh, really? So, okay.
Ever. Oh, I will never touch that.
So, you won't be friends with your friend's ex, or you've never experienced your friends being friends with your ex?
Well, ex and someone you talk to.
Talk to, it happens all the time.
Yeah.
Well, talk to is like a different situation.
Talk to, I don't care.
But relationship-wise, have you remained friends with your friend, with the exes of your friends, yeah, and vice versa?
We actually do have a friend that we're friends with.
That are exes?
Yeah.
Why do you have
that? So cool.
The one girl that you talked to about how Dante was pushing to her.
What?
Oh, her? No.
Yeah.
No. I'm talking about,
Well, that she was kind of like family, though. Like, I mean, because she was family even before, like, so she was in a relationship.
Yeah.
Okay.
I just don't, when it comes to, like, friends, exes, I'm always cordial with everybody. So if I see you somewhere, I'm always like, hi, how you doing? But that's it. Like,
But if they happen to, like, push up on you, then, like,
I can't do it. I can't.
Really?
Yeah, I'm.
It's a mental block where it's just like, nah.
Yeah, it's loyal. I'm loyal to my
friends. If it's something, like, super old and, like, they were involved with each other years
And what
ago.
Do you expect the same of your friends?
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Now, if I did feel, like, that connection that you're talking about, if I did feel it, I'm going straight to my friend.
Because what if the connection with you, the girl, and your friend wasn't there, but you feel something with you and the girl? Like, everyone knew that the relationship with them and that girl was, like, not it. They were really entertaining bullshit just to humor it. Like, they weren't meant for each other and people knew it.
Yeah.
But, like, y'all click.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm a side.
You a side nigga?
I'll be a side.
Dante just
with to your friend? That's fucked up.
How's that fucked up?
Because you a side nigga
because
to your
that's
friend's
not honest,
girl.
Yeah, that's some slime ball shit, right? I'm not going to hold
that's
you.
That's fucked up.
Wait, I mean, wait. I wouldn't care. Like, cause I know how people are.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about it.
Why really are we entertaining about you being like a mistress?
Yo,
first of all.
Dante's a side. A proud
all,
side
Dante
nigga.
Dante just likes being in the house and doesn't want to be known. So, like,
ooh,
he loves
that's
being
a great
side
analogy, bro.
Great analogy.
That's just a fact.
I like to be in the house but not be known. That's a great analogy about me.
I didn't think it was that deep. Like, I
think about it that deep. That's really a great example to describe me. But anyways, let's think about it.
He's mad surprised. Like,
yeah, because I never... That's a great way to think about me. Like, I'm just here.
Damn your face.
Yo, Dante.
Because he sounds so honored about
Dante,
it.
Dante, you got to want better for your life, man. I'm not going to lie.
Be a hoe, be a hoe. Live your life.
Wait.
But, hey. But
she said, I'm speaking.
We're not saying like.
Yeah, took out the most. Talk your shit.
She said, hush.
Like, if you're gonna be a hoe, be a hoe. Like, live your life as you do. Just be smart about it. But why would you want to be hidden? Like, do you not respect yourself?
No. There's certain things, though, because I understand it's like you don't want people in your life, so you want to be as private as fucking possible.
Okay.
And it's not necessarily about wanting to be hidden. It's just like. No one needs to know what the fuck we're doing. So why the fuck are you speaking about it?
Okay.
Yeah.
But, like, you're not looking to put yourself on, like, People Magazine or, like, in the eye of gossip.
Well,
but, like...
Well, when Karan said
that...
No, I don't. I would never be on People Magazine. Well, when Karan said that...
He was like, you want to be in the house, but you want to be hidden. So, like, you want to be included, but you don't want to be...
He doesn't want other people in. He doesn't want other people looking in on what's
his
going
shit,
on.
But he wants to be a part of it. Is that it?
He
I'm
wants
kinda...
to be included in it.
Well,
not...
okay.
Because this kind of sounds more so like the outside looking in thing to me. Like, that's what it sounds like.
When he said that, I wasn't just thinking about it on a whole perspective. I was thinking about it like mentally, like. I just, like, I want to be in the house and let nobody know that I'm there type shit. Like, it's like me
physically
living.
Physically in the house.
Yeah, it's like if I'm at Henry's, or like, if I'm in a party, like, I'm there. But I don't want nobody to know that I'm there.
Like, you would park your car, like, in the next street to make sure no one sees that you're there.
Yeah, because I'm very private.
Okay, but what does that have to do with, like...
Yeah, so going back to what he's saying with the whole friend... I didn't explain it. Okay.
Yeah, that's
so
what I'm saying.
I'm trying to explain. Okay, Let's say Karana talking to somebody, right? Talking. Keyword is talking.
See, and people get that, like, people get dating and, like,
yes.
What is it? Dating,
a talking exclusive, phase. Exclusive with, like, each other.
Well, I think dating and talking, I think those are the two things. And, well, of course, relationships. Yeah. So those are the three
because
things.
Because dating can be, like, dating around. Because
that,
can be very
loose. Like,
exactly.
Dating. Exactly.
But talking is more, like,
you're feeling it
inclusive,
out.
Like,
yeah, one-on-one type
shit. Yeah, it's more like you're not going to talk to a lot of people.
Yeah.
Like, you would date a lot of people, but you would talk to one person. And
yeah.
Why are you making my face?
I would feel like that's the complete opposite, because once I'm dating you, you could date other people, yeah, but, like, I feel like dating is not necessarily exclusive, but, like, talking is more so, like, I'm trying to get to know you. That's before the dating stage for me.
That's what I feel.
Talking is before the dating. Because you could also talk to mad people. Like, you could talk to whatever eggs you have in your basket. You could also date whatever eggs you have in your basket.
I don't
view talking as exclusive.
You just need to be, like, transparent about it.
Because you're just trying to figure out who that person is and to see if they match with you at that time being.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, I don't like any of the terms, because I feel like it all makes it, like, very difficult.
Complicated.
I feel like it should literally just be, like, you're in a relationship or
you're not.
Literally just...
An entanglement?
I don't even like saying dating. Even dating can be like, oh, like, we're dating, so yeah, it could be exclusive.
Well, situation.
I just like a relationship and maybe just talking.
Okay, so let's say Karan had a situation with a woman, right? Not dating, just a situation.
A situation.
An
entanglement.
Yeah. And so he... Shout out to August. So he brings...
Fuck that toxic ass Virgo.
So he brings her to our little gatherings, right?
Mm.
He has no interest in dating her at all.
Okay.
They just have an understanding about what they're doing right now, which is pleasing each other's needs.
Okay.
Pleasing each other's needs.
Yeah. He could have said that less uncomfortably, yeah. But okay.
No, I just like the way he put it. That's funny.
Sorry. So, me and Shorty click, as Karan says.
Okay.
We have, like, a good vibe and stuff, right?
Okay.
And in Karan's example, I end up feeling Shorty. Mm. I end up feeling Shorty. Right? End up feeling her. And I know that Karan isn't feeling her. Right? Karan's just messing with her because right now it's what he needs in his life. Right? So, if Shorty hit me up on some, like, what you doing type shit, you want to come over type shit, if she hit me up
first. But you'd like, be like, hey, are you okay if I do this? So, like, you don't want to get into any deep shit and be like,
but as a guy,
guys,
if I know what it is,
that. Guys are not like hitting.
Okay, that's how y'all spread STDs.
We wrap up.
I wrap up.
Yeah, they wrap
hypothetically.
Up. But as a guy,
hypothetically,
like in our hypothetical,
like, well, yeah, like Sam, honestly, keep it a buck. They knew every woman that I brought around them. They knew what time it was between me and that woman.
Okay.
They would know if that's mentally exclusive or if that's just a girl I'm with, just to bring around. Like, they would know.
Personally, I feel like I would want my friends to be transparent with me.
Okay.
Because, like, I don't want to get involved with unnecessary drama.
Okay.
Mm. Like, it doesn't matter if it's, like, from the friend or from their... I don't want to say SO because we're, like, we're trying to, like, be, like, not, like, their partner. I don't want to get unnecessary stress in my life from either person.
Mm.
So it isn't even a matter of, like, oh, gender roles. Like, it's more so, like, I feel as a person, you owe it to be upfront and honest.
Yep.
No matter what is the situation of entanglement or lack thereof or more than.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, if you feel a vibe between you and the girl that your friend is currently seeing,
mm-hmm.
you say something first and you're like, yo, you good with this? Like, you don't just do it.
Because
I feel like if you go and do it, you're just getting yourself involved in something that might end up being worse.
That might.
That's fair.
But I guess it also depends on, like, where the friend holds. Because honestly, I'll be very honest. I'm not going to put any names out there. But one of my very good friends, excuse me, literally, he's hooked up with definitely two that, like, he's literally hooked up with them, like, told me about it, like, explained everything in detail. But he, like, but he knows, like, I can care less. Like, I'm not on that. So, I mean, but I can imagine, like, I don't know, telling Dante that or some shit. But honestly, I don't know if he would care, but.
I mean, you tell me,
I don't know. I wouldn't do it, but, like, I wouldn't do it, but.
Yeah.
It's, like, I do understand it because, like, I could have it done to me, but, like, mm-hmm. I just think differently from other people.
I mean, TBT to, well, even though it's Sunday, but throwback to when literally all of us used to date the same guy in high school.
Cool.
Well, I feel like there's not many options.
Okay, I'm talking about the girl group.
Yeah, hey, me, nigga.
We literally pass around the same two dudes, and you know exactly who they are.
This nigga hates this nigga so much.
I don't. That was a homie, but I'm just like, why? What? Like, come on.
You know exactly who the same exact friend group, and it's funny because we're not all this friends now.
Flourishing,
but
Goshen, man. I don't know how the niggas like that are we're flourishing. Like, come
it's
on now.
Goshen was like, you are funny.
Oh my God. I mean, Goshen is like kind of small. Like, everywhere around where we live is small. So I'm not surprised you're like, saying that because the same kind of stuff happened in my school. Like, I remember these two girls, like, having a whole fight in the lunchroom because one girl got cheated on by this one guy with another girl, and we were all in the same grade except for him. And then they just went ballistic. And I'm like, okay, this is stupid.
Excuse me.
Sounds like
it really was.
Like, yeah.
It was high school. It was high school. That's why I'm just laughing about this entire conversation because, like, y'all dudes are talking about this, but, like, I fully remember my entire friend group throwing around the same two guys, and we all dated the same two guys.
And y'all act like nothing was wrong with it.
Yup. And now we just shit on their lives.
That's the fun part.
Because it's
always a fun
part. One thing, maybe it's part of, like, your growing path. I don't know. Maybe, like, I feel like every person, to some degree, has, like, a little part.
A little dabble.
A little part in, like, your path.
There's nothing wrong with dabbling.
There's nothing wrong with dabbling. I definitely told my friends that.
You learn about yourself. You learn what you like, what you don't like. You also learn, like, what type of people that you need in your life and what you should get rid of and so on and so forth. So if you feel a vibe, you feel the vibe. But don't, like, it's not necessarily betraying your friend because, like, if they're just talking. But, like, if you trust and respect them, you would expect the same for you.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, maybe we just don't respect ourselves.
I'm sorry.
Y'all sound like y'all respect yourselves more than the friend group in high school.
I think it's not respect. I think we just know what it is, bro. Like, I can tell. No, but I can tell. You could tell what a man thinks about a woman by the way he treats her around his friends.
Okay,
in my
opinion. Not every man is like every man and every woman like
sometimes
every woman.
Sometimes men are very fucking oblivious and stupid.
That's
like, they don't be saying that.
If you two have a mutual understanding of each other, that is respect. Yeah. Like, that is you understand each other. You understand what one another likes, hates, and whatever else. So that shows that you care and respect about one another, because why else would you remember any of that if you didn't?
I mean,
and you shouldn't really go off and saying, like, I know what it is, because a lot of people, like, they could just front, like, they'll be like, oh, like, we're not anything, I don't like her like that, but deep down inside, like, he really cares about her.
No,
but then that's your fault for not fucking saying something. To be honest with you, it's about communication.
But so, not everyone wants, like, you in their life and know what's going on.
But that's your fault. That's your fault. Deadass accountability. If you didn't want that shit and you're not verbalizing that, even though that's what you want, you're a dumbass for not speaking on that.
Yeah. But also, because
now you're hiding something, realizing, like, you know what you want. You didn't verbalize what you wanted.
Facts.
And now you're the one getting butthurt, and that's your own fault. So only you could be mad at yourself for not vocalizing what you wanted.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And also, to
speak
me,
now or
body language.
Hold your peace.
Yeah. Body language speaks volumes to me. So yeah, you don't, so because they don't say how they feel about the person, but the way they act around them, the body language and how they present the woman, to me speaks volumes. So if I see homeboy bringing, let's say, I'm not gonna go around. Let's say one of my friends brought this girl over and paid her no attention. She was in the corner the whole time, not even talking to her at this function. I already know what kind of perspective that he holds this girl. So if that's the case, then you just brought her around so that you have somebody to come with.
Yeah.
Type shit. Which I've done before, so I understand
but
that.
I feel like we communicate that too, like prior. Like,
we could,
we'll be like, oh, like.
Okay, you're right. Whatever. Okay. So we actually do communicate, but we don't come out and ask.
It's not like
you
that.
Mess with them.
It's not
like
that
a.
Blatant. Like, we're not.
Yeah. It's like guys.
We're not dogs like that. Like, oh, we're dumb guys, but we're not like dogs.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to praise myself, I promise.
Yeah.
So yeah. I got nothing to say. I got no comment.
I don't know how
Does
we got here.
Does this relate to your point guard dude?
Point guard dude?
Scottie Pippen.
Oh, snap.
Oh, look at
the segue. Oh. Okay, I see you. I see you. Well, listen, I'm about to defend Shorty, bro, because I don't see nothing wrong.
Her too, because I think it's like kind of
stupid. I don't think nothing's wrong with her. So, Laza Pippen? Yeah, Laza Pippen.
Grown-ass woman.
Like, yeah.
Laza Pippen, formerly with Scottie Pippen, which I don't know why
one
she still has.
One of the greatest of all time.
Facts. Even though Very MJ don't think so.
Okay, I know this sounds really ignorant, but is he...
Yes. Got it? Yeah.
Okay, because why did every article sound like he was like gone?
That's kind of the thing. Like the since the 90s, like they always say he's like the Batman, like or the Robin to like a Batman. So they always say people take advantage of him. Mm-hmm. So I guess it's kind of like even played out with his relationship, because you know, like he played with Michael Jordan, so Michael Jordan always got like the praise and like he helped a lot and.
Mm-hmm. Really a whole bunch.
Really couldn't probably do it without him.
Without Scotty, yep.
It's like people just take advantage. So people like always say he's dead.
So that's why he's kind of talked about in a past tense, even though he's... That's interesting.
Yeah. I feel bad for Scotty.
But he's like really cool. He's super cool. Like he's super quiet. Like he's like...
Mm-hmm. Chill dude.
Like...
It seems like his son is kind of similar.
Yeah.
Because
like Pippen Jr.
when they probably prompted him for a response of some sort, or maybe he just felt like, I need to defend my mom, which like... You know, good on you both ways, but like, you don't owe them a response because clearly they're just sifting for drama.
Yeah, it's just drama shit. But it's hard. It's your mother. It's like, you see that.
But is it, it's not the first time she was involved.
No.
Oh, no.
Well, she recently, not recently, back then the joke was that Larsa left Scotty for Future. They had a little shit.
Well, they broke up. Like, they were separated, so they were seeing other people. So there's nothing like they're grown ass.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Like, they're separate because like they were married for 20 years and like it's very complicated. Exactly. So they're not just gonna get a divorce. So they're seeing other people.
Yeah.
And, like she's dating other guys.
She's dating younger men.
Yeah.
And people are looking at her,
criticizing her.
He was seeing others too.
Yeah. Well,
okay.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So people are saying, oh my god, she's with Malik Beasley.
Yeah.
He's like 22, 20, 23, I believe. And he apparently was in a relationship, I guess, and didn't tell his ex. So she found out, like, oh, my God, that kind of stuff, you know, regular nigga shit. So then she recently, they had a thing with Bronny James.
LeBron James' son.
LeBron James' son. He commented on a picture of her, which is, it wasn't even like a crazy picture. It was like a simple picture, like a simple selfie.
Wasn't it just them holding hands?
Yeah, something like that.
Simple.
And then people thought that she was being a pedophile, blah, blah, blah. And then she put out a tweet, which was a nasty tweet.
I've been separated, going through a divorce for over 2 years, and I've been linked to a few guys my entire life. So that don't shit crazy. Here and paint a picture of me that isn't true.
Which?
I mean, that's honest, though.
It's honest.
Like, if you're going to have your image slandered for something that's not true, like, but let the person speak their truth.
But going off of Quran, you don't have to respond to everything that is said about you in the public, in my opinion. And the fact that she's a mom and
I wouldn't say that was the worst way to respond, though.
No, but there was another tweet that came out that said, she mentioned somebody else, like, so-and-so dates younger people and y'all have a problem with it. It was something like that. I'm probably saying it overly wrong. I'm sorry if I'm butchering it, but she said something like that, comparing what she's doing to somebody else.
Yeah, no, and it just not looked everyone's bad. Situation is the same.
Exactly.
You can't do that.
So,
but that also applies to her tweet, which was saying, like, don't sit here and paint a picture that's not true. Yeah.
Exactly. I don't have a problem with her dating. Like, she can date who the fuck she wants.
That's not the problem. I don't think the problem is her dating, like, the problem, because she's a beautiful woman, so she wants to go out, so she's just seen out in public. Like, Scottie Pippen, he's super low-key. Like, he dates, too, but he's probably, like, very low-key in the house. Like,
but how is he able to maintain that?
Because he doesn't, like, he's not out. Like, she's just, like, she goes out to clubs, so
she's finally single.
Like, Scottie Pippen, like, he's old. I mean, they're both kind of older, but he's, like, a retired basketball player, so he's not trying to be out like that. Mm-hmm. You know, he has a ton of money, so he's probably just at his house or at a hotel. But she actually, like, she's beautiful. She goes out, goes to events. So she has friends, and, like, she's a grown-ass woman. Mm-hmm. Like, she can do whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Like, why are people on her dick about that?
Exactly. I don't.
It's like you're.
What if the rules were reversed, though?
Yeah.
What you say?
What if the rules were reversed?
Oh, it'll be fine.
Yeah, like
they wouldn't even bat an eye.
No deal.
They wouldn't even bat an eye if like there was an older man. If Future was. Nah, oh yeah,
like Scottie Pippen.
Nah, but we're Future and Lori Harvey. Lori Harvey's like 20 years old. Future was what, like 40, 30 something?
No, he's like 36, but.
That's the big age difference. That's nothing serious?
I mean, my grandma and grandpa were 20 years
apart. No, that's a fact. My parents are definitely. Yeah.
My grandparents more than 45.
But then again, that was like the second one.
45?
But either
who's older, has a son, it's my grandpa? My grandma's age.
Was that in
like, I understand. It's less stigmatized. I don't know. It's stupid, but it's less stigmatized for the man to be the older partner.
Exactly.
And especially when there's a large age gap.
Talking about your grandpa's.
Like,
well, we having a whole conversation over here, bro. Y'all talking about grandpas.
Sorry, y'all three.
Yo, his grandpa has a whole 45-year-old difference with his woman. Like
45?
45!
My grandpa and my grandmother are like 40 years apart. Like, I have his oldest son is the same age as my grandmother.
That's wild.
Yo, love he it. Was on the earth before she
exactly.
I don't like that. That's weird in
see,
any
but context. Like, yeah, but this is like normal. Back in the day, like it was more normalized. Like,
okay.
He just
but it's still low key is normalized. Wow. Year, but, oh, RIP.
Yeah, but he's like that was just a thing. Like he was not from this country. Like that was just a thing back.
Oh,
in the day.
Well, yeah, I get that with like the islands. I know it's gonna be different over there. But even you in the US, it's normalized for a man to be older than a woman and dating them. But when a woman is older than the man, it looks like differently.
Yo, doesn't Tina Turner have like a 22-year-old boyfriend?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Fucking I respect it.
Her. Don't like Janet Jackson just married like a young.
No, she got divorced and took all his money.
Oh, she got
divorced and took all his money after she got pregnant.
Goddamn.
She got the bag.
It was a prince.
Don't the Jacksons have like her brother's empire? Like.
Bro, they got the Jackson family just dirty. I can't. Their empire's just insane.
That's a fact.
Yeah, why don't they have a show? Why did the Kardashians they got enough have a money show and they don't?
They got a whole.
I feel like
money.
I'd rather follow that.
They had a show. They had did? A show. The brothers had a show.
When?
The brothers had a show in high school. Someone Google that. Yes.
Oh, what's it called? Yeah, they definitely had a show. They definitely.
Thank you.
Had a show.
I'm not
but it wasn't
bugging.
Like that big.
Honestly, no one was really. Nobody I feel like. Yeah, I feel like no one was really.
I watching. Think even Michael Jackson didn't Paris and Blake. Like, well, I think Michael Jackson's kid had a. They had a little reality
I didn't know
show
that.
Too. I no, definitely
I
saw
it.
I would watch his kids' shows.
Mm. Yeah, it was very
I would watch Blanket in Paris. And who's the other one?
Blanket.
Snow.
It's not Snow. No. It's not know. Snow. You were guessing that shit.
I would hope that
oh,
Blanket
shit.
Changed her name.
Yeah. That's not funny, Karai. I just call it.
I mean, there's Gwyneth Paltrow and Apple.
Apple?
Apple.
These names, man. I'm gonna name my son. Yo, Karan, no, I was no. on the chatty house, man.
I heard. That was your experience.
Yo, it's actually a very fun app. And I wanted to invite you, but I didn't want to waste my one invite. I only got one invite.
He said you ain't worth it.
No,
that's crazy.
Because he's not going to use it.
Thought like that, because I'm definitely not.
He's not going to use it. But it's very, it's a great app. You would love the app. It's very
like.
So
what's the premise? So it's like. So the people who can actually talk are just people who are verified.
Who make the rooms. No, you just have to make the rooms. Whoever makes the room.
You can make your own room.
Yes.
They got like a shit ton of different topics. It's actually really cool.
Each room is a different topic.
Yeah.
Yes, each room is a different topic.
Okay.
Exactly. So today I was in a room with like Joe Budden and some other people, right? So they have like a hand raise thing. So
a hand raise?
Yeah. So if you press the hand raise, you could raise your hand to talk.
Is that new?
No, it's always been there.
That sounds like Zoom.
Yeah, so oh. yeah, so not everybody could talk. Whoever makes the room and whoever adds like the moderators to the room can talk. But everybody else that joins the room, they can't talk yet unless they say so.
Okay.
So it was really dope. So I was in a bunch of rooms with like podcast rooms.
You were raising your hand like 10 times.
I wasn't.
No,
I don't like to talk to people. I don't want to talk to these niggas.
I mean, you should. It would help with networking.
I did network, though, because people did hit me up out of it. I was just there,
but
people still hit me up.
You can hit them up, too.
Bro, I was like the 2500th of line. I'm not saying
okay,
I was up till 2 a.m. to talk, and I didn't talk.
That's shocking.
So I went, my ass is dead, okay? I don't got time for this. I don't got time for that.
She said you didn't open your mouth?
I tried. I was in line.
No.
I was in line.
Yo, this is crazy. You got to stand in line.
Stand in line just to talk.
Yo.
Yep.
This world is crazy.
But well, it's a great conversation.
It depends on the group chat that you're
yeah,
in.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. It was like
the
a
West
big
Indy
group.
One with the women.
It was like 26 people in there.
Exactly.
Like yeah. So it depends on the room. But it's a great app. It's a great app.
Cool.
I liked it. I liked
no
it.
No video. It's just like
it's just audio, talking, which so I audio. Fucking love because I don't
honestly
see you.
It was like a conference call. I didn't like that shit. I couldn't
so, like,
do that.
Discord?
I thought I was in a 9-to-5.
Yeah, it sounds like. I mean, yeah, it's cool because I guess yeah, it's good to network. If you're able to get in a small room and like an intimate room, that sounds like it could be helpful.
Exactly. Mm.
But like I said, just like having a big ass room and well, you just listen to people talk pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like IG Live just without the video.
Yeah.
It's like any type of live platform.
I can see that. Were you at least allowed to chat in there? Like,
no.
You couldn't even type so what you were thinking?
You're just listening to
yeah.
people.
It's all audio-based. Everything is audio-based. No text, no.
But you couldn't even talk. You
can't interact or anything.
No, because you didn't make a room. So right now, if I make a room and I could invite Solange, Karan, you, only us can talk. And whoever raises their hand, they'll be allowed to talk.
For how long?
Yo, can we do that for season 3? Can we make a chatting room for season 3?
We're not that popular yet.
We about to have two
he
people
said
in
we're
that
not
room.
Advanced.
Plus, no, but plus not everybody has a thing.
I could see like 15 people in the chatting room while we're just potting and talking and be like, does anyone have a story that they want to share just randomly?
Yeah, but like it's everybody live. Has to have a clubhouse. Not everybody has a clubhouse yet. Like I only saw like 10 people out of my
But if you have an interesting conversation, you don't think people will join that chat?
No, but the thing is that you can't just join it. You have to get invited to join it.
But if you have a good conversation, you don't think people would want to be invited to it? Like if you just don't post your topics on the chatting room, you don't think someone's going to want to talk about them?
I mean, yeah, they will. But it's like, okay, so it's like I can't just have Sam sign up for the chatter house.
You have to invite her. But yeah. You're saying you only had one invite.
You only have one invite. So what I'm saying is either I invite you or you have to wait for Clubhouse to reach out to send you the link so that you can finally get involved. Because I did it like months ago and I didn't get hit up at all. And the only reason why I got invited because of Magic, shout out to Magic, she sent me the invite because of that room.
She has Magic's popping on.
Yeah, she got a clubhouse.
I can see that. Magic be making mad moves. Shout out to Magic.
Shout out to Magic. So
it's like the third time in a row.
I know, so, right?
But shout out to Magic.
I should call Magic. Should I call Magic?
If you want to.
Facts.
Nah, my phone's over there.
You're the only one with her number.
I mean, yeah. I have her number, but she's probably going to dub my shit.
Damn.
Shout out to Magic.
Shout out to Magic. I had another question. I don't remember it. Honestly, I don't feel like talking about nothing else. That's all I got.
Talk about important issues.
You
oh,
want
yeah.
to talk about Jay-Z?
Nah.
What did Jay-Z
do? Nah, the Young Thug.
Do.
The Young Thug and Jay-Z shit. Oh. We're not talking about that shit. We could talk to you about the corona, about the new strand of corona.
There's a new strain?
Yes.
There's a new variant
talk to them,
of
talk
corona.
To them, Sam. Talk to them, Sam.
It seems to have originated in the UK. 15 people have already been diagnosed with that variant in Turkey, at least that we know of. And there's at least one in Ohio, I think, and possibly a couple more in California.
So what are the symptoms of the new strain?
It's no different than Corona as it already is. It's just the only difference is that it may be more resistant towards efforts of like managing and getting rid of those symptoms and the illness overall. Because like when a virus becomes more strong and stubborn, you have a harder time of fighting it.
Yeah.
And that's, like, we already had that issue and are still having that issue, even with, like, the few vaccines that have been coming out. It's just, they may not be as effective,
yeah. Because viruses are, like, always going to mutate and it's always going to be different strands. So, yeah. So we always, it's a constant challenge just to, like, contain
it. Keep up
with
it.
Yeah.
And that's why there's a different type of flu shot, like, every so often. Because that strain of the flu is not going to be the same for, like, 10-20 years, that's you know, true. Like it's gonna change, things change, but like the base will stay the same, but the proteins and everything else that compose it, they change.
Man, this corona shit is like, I'm starting to realize, like, people thought it was just going to be like a few months or a year. No,
it could have been a few months if we weren't fucking American and we stayed our asses inside the fucking house. That's all we need to fucking do.
If we follow lockdown. We literally
just need to stay the fuck inside.
But it's like other
we would not be having this problem. States are not even
like enforcing that, though. That's the thing.
Well, it's people who, like, they either can't control them or they don't believe in it. Yeah. And it's just like you see all these people dying. And albeit, like, some hospitals will be writing off deaths as corona, but that might not be true. That's like, true. For the entirety of the deaths might not be corona.
Yeah.
But there's a good deal of people who have died from this. No, so, definitely. Like, I don't know about you, but I wouldn't be making jokes and acting like things aren't happening if people are actually dying. Mm-hmm.
This would be the perfect time to stay the fuck inside, y'all. I'm just saying. It's February. Who the fuck actually likes going out in this weather right now?
Stay inside.
If you're Nakeem and you're in Atlanta, then...
Okay, I get it, because you're in a state Atlanta, where it's, Florida, like, Carolina. Mad fucking sunny and it's nice out. But, like, honestly...
Yeah, I mean, in New York, there's not anything... Like, nothing's open in New York, so...
Things are open in New York. Well, there's strip clubs open in New York.
Upstate.
There are strip clubs open in New York. I know a couple of strip clubs open in New York.
But, like, shit is open upstate.
And in New Jersey... There's things that are, like, open in New York. There's things that are, depending on the state, this is the one thing that irks me, because there's certain states that are genuinely trying to follow guidelines and other states that don't give a fuck. Mm-hmm. This needs to be, like,
to be
a countrywide, like, rule that we just need to just fucking quarantine, guys, for 2 fucking months. Because there are certain places that don't have museums open, restaurants open, all these things that are not open. And then, like, other states that we clearly don't give a fuck. And then people are flying out from all these different states to come back and just travel.
Like, I don't know how you're going to open museums during a pandemic, because you're going to need to quarantine those items. Like, I know it sounds... Like, when you think about it, you're like, but they're not alive. But it's because... the people bring in the germs, and like, you'll need to quarantine and section off and sanitize and do whatever you need to with, like, those artifacts. But certain things can't be done with certain items because of the age and the materials and everything that, you know, is keeping it together. So I feel like it's not a good time to open things like that.
I feel like it's open with that shit. Philly has no museums open right now.
See, that's smart. It's sad. It's sad because, like, of, but we need, like, to go back history to that. And we art, really do. But it really needs to happen.
If we want everything to open up back up and be, quote unquote, back to normal.
I know. We need a government that actually supports us.
Do you guys think if we were a dictatorship, this would be our, this would be...
Anything besides capitalism? Yeah. Yes.
Well, I mean, okay, but if that's economics. That's not, like, our political system.
Are you positive about that?
Oh, I didn't want to.
Capitalism is, like, how our economy is running. But our politics, our government, they're, like, they might be capitalist. But exactly.
But are we sure about that? We say that. We may not say it's a capitalistic country, but let's be real with ourselves.
Oh, it is
a capitalistic country. If that was the case, I feel like we wouldn't be open, because all we think about and surround ourselves with is the fucking dollar. There's a reason why we're still open and doing this dumbass shit.
But that...
It's not like... I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying, because that's not the correct political term for what our democracy is.
Yeah.
But in reality...
It's because the United States is a very individualist state. They're not collectivist. They only care about person to person.
Mm-hmm.
They don't care about, like, the effect that it poses on the community overall.
Mm-mm.
Which is why, like, whenever people who don't totally agree with capitalism, like, at least, like, I personally say, like, I feel like I'm a cog in the capitalist machine, because, like, I have to work to be able to afford things, to be able to pay off, like, debt, to just be able to function in this world, in this society.
And to be real, if we were, like, a true democracy, like, we would be able to be funded by the government, so we would be okay with being unemployed. Mm-hmm. Or not even necessarily not working, but just, like... The stimulus checks. Every other country that I know of had a decent stimulus check for the people who live in that country to survive.
And then there's us.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe they didn't even need a stimulus check. Like, some countries were just off. Man. Like, they gave a crap about their citizens.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's ours. We're like, hey, Are we voting for the army or are we voting for the people?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I mean, look, we haven't had much of a government the last 4 years, a well-functioning government. No. So it's kind of hard to say. Hopefully, like, within the next 4 years, we'll kind of see more of a change. I'm sure we will see more of a change, but
that's a fact.
For better or for worse.
Hopefully, back on a track progressivism.
We can kind of disguise shit. Like,
I don't got that much faith in Joe Biden, to be honest with y'all.
I mean, I don't have any faith in any politician. Like, they're all just trying to reach their audience. And it's, I don't know. They don't actually, really care.
He's not the person I wanted, but I do believe that he, at least what his platform is with Harris, like, I just feel it would be the switch that we need to get us back on a better track.
I definitely agree.
Hopefully.
I agree.
Dante, no.
No, I was very... I actually really wanted to know about the dictatorship.
I'm actually mad skeptical, but we shall see.
It's a little bit different because we are, we're technically a democracy, but...
Barely.
We're based off of, a republic. And at the same time, we were founded by people who function with a monarchy and a parliament. So it's kind of interesting how we have a definition of what we are, but
we don't follow the guidelines.
But do we fall under any category per se? Sometimes I feel like we don't really. Mm. We say we're a democracy, but are we really?
Mm. Yeah, things over time, it's just evolution. It's we don't stick to the original purpose or meaning why it was what it was built off of. So over time, it's not really a democracy.
Facts.
It's like music. It's like mumble rappers and rap. Stop. Started off as rapping, now it's mumble rap.
That should be still hip hop though.
It'd be hitting.
It'd be hitting. It'd be hitting. Shout out 645 AR.
Yo, she stay shouting out this nigga, bro. This nigga is trash.
Play a 645 AR song.
Play yoga. That's my shit.
Bro, come on, Kron.
645 AR?
Yes.
Okay, you play this, then we're about to end the podcast after you play it.
No, that's a fact.
Yoga, that's the only one.
Okay, Salon, this is your time to shine with your playlist. Let's see.
Y'all are about to hate me. About to get kicked off the soapbox.
I wish we had a Salon drop so we could play. We don't know this fire yet. This so much things to like, so sweet.
Episode 95 of the 96 of the Soapbox. I want to thank everybody listening on Apple, Spotify, and YouTube. Make sure you unfollow Salon for playing that wacky ass fucking song.
It was hard though.
You know,
tell
what I'm
me
saying?
That beat was not hard.
Sorry, Dante. We keep messing up his outro. The beat was hard. It was like some Playboi Carti-ish.
Thank you.
That was not Playboi Carti.
It was in the realm.
What? Make sure you guys follow us on Apple, Instagram, Twitter. Make sure y'all stay safe. You know what I'm saying?
Wear your mask. Get tested.
Only 4 episodes left. 4 episodes left. You know what I mean? No, facts. I'ma holler at y'all.
Just gonna retire. After 100, we should just retire, yo.
Imagine. 100.
We out.
We out.